And another good morning to you from Mission Control Houston, and welcome to our continuing coverage of HTV-5 and its flight to the International Space Station. You're joining us with a quick look inside the International Space Station Flight Control Room, where the Orbit One team still on console, as they have been all morning overseeing the final stages of the fifth Japanese cargo vehicle's arrival to the International Space Station. You can see it here attached just a few feet away now from its berthing port on the Earth-facing side of the Harmony module. The robotics controllers able to get well ahead of their timeline. The original schedule had it being berthed at about 8:45 a.m. Central Time, but here we sit now at 7 a.m., only about 5 feet away from that berthing port. And just a little while, it's going to be moved to a little bit closer location, about 2 feet away from, again, that berthing port on the Earth-facing side of Harmony. And then as the robotics controllers continue to make sure everything is lined up and ready, they'll be able to move it in for that final attachment, and then we'll wait until the bolts are in place and berthing is complete. Meanwhile, on board the International Space Station, the Expedition 44 crew continuing with their day. Two of those crew members, Camille Yui and Chell Lindgren, were at the controls of the station's robotic arm, which has HTV-5 firmly in its grasp right now for that capture, which did take place about 20 minutes ahead of the timeline at around 5:28 a.m. Central Time this morning, while the station and HTV were flying just over the southern part of Brazil and South America. Since that time, Yui handed over controls of the robotic arm to the teams down here on the ground, and they have maneuvered HTV to this pre-install point, where it is now lined up straight away with the berthing port on the Earth-facing side of Harmony. So within the hour, we should expect to see that berthing to the International Space Station and the arrival of over 4.5 tons of cargo to the International Space Station, close to 5 tons actually, 9,500 pounds all told, with 8,000 in the pressurized section, which will is at the top of the vehicle, going to be attached to the station. Then 1,400 pounds in the exposed facility. You can see the experiment just down there, the Calet experiment. It's a calorimetric electron telescope that is going to be extracted from HTV and handed off to the robotic arm over on the exposed facility of the Japanese experiment module, where it will be installed and perform its astrophysics experiment data takes, searching for evidence of dark matter and the source of cosmic rays. For now, though, HTV-5 sits poised just a few feet away from its final berthing port, having completed just a little over 5 days. It's actually been 5 days and 12 minutes since HTV-5 launched from the Tanegashima Space Center in Japan, and has since performed all of its flight milestones without any issues, arriving at this point now where it is currently grappled and ready to be berthed within the hour to the International Space Station. And again, pretty soon, the next robotic maneuver will take place, and HTV-5 will be moved from its current position just 5 feet away to a little bit closer. It'll be just 2 feet away from the berthing port. At that point, Robo will pause for a little while, wait for the crew members on board to be in position, as well as all the teams down here on the ground to be go for that berthing. So that should be coming up in just a little while. We'll see some motion on the arm again as HTV continues to make its way a little bit closer as the minutes tick by to its berthing port on the International Space Station. HTV-5 continuing to close in inch by inch now. Very slow and methodical movement of the space station's robotic arm, Canada Arm 2, to which the several-ton spacecraft is currently grappled. At the end of this maneuver, it'll only be 2 feet away from that berthing port. And again, it'll pause there for a little while until everyone's in place. Currently on board, three of the crew members, Expedition 44 Commander Gennady Padalka, and the 2 1-year crew members, Mikhail Kornienko and NASA's Scott Kelly, doing some leak checks on their Sokol launch and entry suits.
Station Huntsville on Space to Ground 2 for Kimia. No response required. This is your 15-minute reminder for your ham pass coming up at the rise time of 12:23. Huntsville copies. Sounds good.
So the robotics officer here in Mission Control, Houston, confirming HTV now at the 2-foot hold point. Arriving there just a minute ago at 7:12 a.m. Central Time. HTV's going to camp out here for just a little while until a crew member is available on board the station to help oversee the final berthing operations. So again, HTV-5 going to hold here for a little while until my crew member, Scott Kelly, the NASA astronaut, currently timelined to be the one to assist for the actual berthing of the vehicle. Once he's in place, essentially, the robotics flight controllers are going to command the space station's robotic arm to maneuver HTV into the berthing port and put it into what's known as a ready-to-latch or an RTL position. Following that, Kelly will send commands to the common berthing mechanism to initiate all of the latches and then drive a series of 16 bolts to engage and then perform a tight fit and make sure HTV is in place.
Station Houston on 2 for Chell at your convenience.
The Japanese astronaut Koichi Wakata is still at the Capcom position here in Houston, getting ready to hand over to oncoming Capcom Doug Wheelock.
We are moving along on the HTV maneuver and in berthing operation. Scott is scheduled for an O2 Nader CBM capture and enabled task at 1355. And if possible, we would like to have your help on that procedure as Scott is in the Russian segment for the Sokol leak check. And let us know if you can help us with the capture and enabled steps.
Absolutely.
Okay, then you are go to perform the task that is scheduled for Scott at 1355.
Okay, and do you want me to perform that on time, or do you want me to get started now?
Standby one, Chell.
So the flight control team's here working with NASA astronaut Chell Lindgren to see if they can move this berthing operation up a little bit earlier. Crew member Scott Kelly was originally scheduled to perform all the bolting commands, but he's over in the Russian segment right now doing leak checks on a Sokol launch and entry suit along with two of his fellow Russian cosmonauts. So the team's looking at getting NASA astronaut Chell Lindgren in to see if he could take over at a little bit earlier time.
Station Houston on 2 for Chell for CBM.
And go on to
Chell, thank you for the wait. First, we would like you to review the CBM pre-made verification steps that was already completed by Scott earlier. And the procedure is 1-511 No2 CBM verify pre-made status, which was completed by Scott earlier. So we would like you to review the steps 1-3 of the procedure. And then after we review the steps, please let us know, and then we will give you a go for further steps.
Okay, copy. I'm going to be reviewing steps 1-3 and 1.511, and then I'll get back to you.
Thank you, sir.
So the teams here in Mission Control continuing to work well ahead of their timelines for HTV today, able to get Schellengren over to help do this berthing operation a little bit earlier than scheduled. Right now, the robotics officer going to be sending some commands to continue moving HTV towards that berthing port. It's going to stop at about 40 centimeters away. And then once they get the go-ahead from Chell that he's ready, they're going to press into what's known as the ready-to-latch position. Basically have HTV inside the common berthing mechanism and ready for the crew to basically implement the capture sequence.
Station Houston on 2, no response required for exercise. We are in the no exercise constraints at this time, and this constraint will continue until the CBM A bolt is complete.
we're continuing to stand by as we move into the final phases of today's HTV operation. It's just a little over 2 hours and 1 minute actually since HTV was captured by the Expedition 44 crew. Since then, robotics controllers have moved it into its pre-install position, centimeters away now from the berthing port of the Earth-facing side of Harmony.
Operations.
Go ahead, Chell on two.
Koichi, I am complete with a review of 1.511. Your go for maneuver to ready to latch position.
Will you copy that? Thanks. And Chell, Robo is still lining up the HDB for the CBM, and we'll get back with you when you can proceed to the next step.
Okay, copy. Standing by.
And NASA astronaut Chell Lindgren reporting he's standing by, ready to go. So the robotics officer here in Houston going to start maneuvering HTV-5 into that ready-to-latch position, basically having it right inside the common berthing mechanism, ready for Chell to send commands to drive the bolts and latch HTV firmly in place. As a reminder, the vehicle will be considered berth once we get confirmation of second stage capture.
Koichi, in the meantime, do you still need the current lab camera view, or can I put it back to nominal positioning?
Checking. Chell, thanks for asking, and you can take the camera back to the nominal config.
Copy, thanks.
And there's going to be a hold here now for a little while. The robotics officer having some requirements for good, solid video connection with the station, and it gets a little spotty over the next 20 minutes or so. So they're going to pause the HTV operations here, and then picking back up at about 7:54 a.m. Central Time, at which point they'll be ready to drive HTV in, and then the crew members will bolt it in place, and then HTV-5 will be attached and ready for unloading in the next day or so by the Expedition 44 crew. So again, we're just going to pause the operations here for a little bit until we get that good video connection back with the International Space Station, at which point all these final HTV actions will be taken and berthing will be complete.
Thanks for the update.
Station Houston on Space to Ground 2 for Chell and CBM Ops.
Hey, Wheels, I'm here on 2.
Hey, Chell, good to work with you again today. Hey, we've got a KU gap here that we're going to pick back up at 12:54. So you can stand down on the CBM watching and monitoring there until 12:54, then we'll pick back up. We weren't able to complete all the robotics ops prior to this KU gap. I'll give you a call when we're ready to start up.
Copy. Hey, and we'll...
And Station Houston on Space to Ground 2, we went into a short handover there. Could you say again your last?
Yeah, Wheels, I'm back from the leak check. It all went well. I was just wondering if maybe I just missed hitting record on one of those items on the pre-made status.
Yeah, copy, Scott. We're in a good config. We were just having Chell. We were a little bit ahead on the timeline. We had Chell doing some work that was on your timeline, but we're back in a good config. We're going to pick back up with CBM ops at 12:54.
So as you just heard, oncoming Capcom, Doug Wheelock, relay up to the crew. They'll be picking up in about 14 minutes from now with the Common Berthing Mechanism, or CBM Ops, to get HDV attached to the International Space Station. The robotics officer needing some good video connection from the station in order to do these final maneuvers, so that coverage will lock back up at about 7:54 a.m. Central Time. So the team's here for now just standing by for a couple of minutes until they can complete this final operation, get HTV attached, and call it a day for all of the activities with this vehicle from down here. Once it is attached, the crew will spend a couple of hours just outfitting what's known as the vestibule, basically doing a number of leak checks and ensuring a tight seal and everything okay between the station itself and HTV. And once it's attached, you can see what the station makeup will be just here. This will only be like this for a couple of days, actually, though, is a little bit later on this week on Friday, that Soyuz 42 at the space-facing side of the station is going to be relocated out to the very back end of the Zvezda service module. That will free up the Poisk module on top of the station for the arrival of the next Soyuz vehicle, Soyuz TMA-18M, which is set to launch on Tuesday, September 1st, if you're in Central. If you're in the Eastern, it'll be early in the morning at 12:30 in the morning on September 2nd, and it'll bring three crew members up to the International Space Station, among them Russian cosmonaut Sergei Volkov, who will be making his third flight to the International Space Station. He'll be joined by two first-time flyers, Adin Ambatov from the Kazakh Space Agency and Andreas flew up in that's going to get relocated to the aft end of Zvezda in a complex bit of rearranging on board the station, but that'll end the 6 month on board for Padalka, but also leave Kelly and Kornienko, who are remaining on board until March of next year with a fresh Soyuz, and they'll be coming home in March of 2016 along with Volkov, who will be the new crew member on board. Scott Kelly will also take command of Expedition 45 following the departure of Gennady Padalka, who will leave the station with more time and space than any human being, wrapping up his fifth flight into space, his fourth on board the International Space Station. So quite a vehicle operations for the Expedition 44 crew this week, and looking forward to getting a few new crew members up next week when they'll have 9 crew members on board for 10 days. The first time that that's happened since the Olympic torch was flown up to space just a couple of years ago in advance of the Winter Olympics out in Russia. But for now, we're continuing to stand by for about another 10 minutes or so until we, again, reacquire that video communication with the International Space Station and we can continue the final phases of getting HTV-5 attached.
Station Houston on Space to Ground 2 for Scott and the timeline.
Yeah, go ahead, Wills.
Hey, Scott, we have a kind of a near-term plan for you here. Thanks for your patience. Because of comm coverage, both KU and S-band, a couple of blocks coming up, we're going to let you guys have a break right now. Would suggest maybe midday meal at this point, and then we'll pick back up in the normal timeline at 13:25.
Okay, sounds good.
And so just then, Capcom Doug Wheelock reporting up to the crew. Comm's still looking a little bit spotty in the near term, so they're actually going to stand down, let the crew go get a bite to eat, and then they're going to resume all of these HTV berthing operations at 13:25 GMT, so that'll be 8:25 a.m. Central Time this morning. So video reacquired right now for a little bit, and it'll pop in and out for the next 40 minutes or so until they're ready to start back up, and they'll lock back in on good video and audio communication to continue the final stages of this berthing operation. But for now, HDV-5 just going to sit real close, just a few centimeters away from the berthing port on the Earth-facing side of Harmony. And in about 30 minutes or so, 30 or 40 minutes, the crew will get back in place and the robotics officers will conduct their final maneuvers and then get ready to attach HTV-5 to the International Space Station. So again, just kind of hanging out for a little bit longer until 8:25 a.m. Central Time when all of the final operations should resume. So getting closer to the top of the hour, just a reminder that pausing until a good solid chunk of video and audio communications with the space station are available. This current data pass will only last for about 10 minutes or so. So after that, it'll be pretty spotty until right around 8:25 or so a.m. Central Time, at which everything will lock back up, and then the final operations to install HTV will resume. And it's been just a little over 2.5 hours since HTV-5 was captured successfully with that robotic arm. That capture coming at 5:28 a.m. Central, 6:28 a.m. Eastern. While both the station and HTV flew just over the southern part of Brazil and South America, HTV-5 packed with over 4.5 tons of cargo for the International Space Station, among it over 8,000 pounds of pressurized goods, including supplies for the crew, also fresh experiment hardware for much of the ongoing research on board the International Space Station. So again, just going to sit tight for the next 20 minutes or so until we get into a good position for the final operations. The crew members on board, either Scott Kelly or Chell Ingren, depending on who they go back to, will be at the common berthing mechanism ready to enable all of the bolts to hold HTV in place once the robotics controller has put it into its final ready-to-latch position. And once we get confirmation of second stage capture, we will consider HTV-5 berth to the space station, and that'll wrap it up for all the activities down here on the ground, at least for HTV today. The crew members will have a few hours to outfit the connection between the station and HTV and conduct a series of leak checks. And the current plan calls for the hatch to be opened in the early hours tomorrow morning, at which point Japanese astronaut Kamiya Yui and NASA astronaut Chell Ingren will be able to head inside and begin removing the internal cargo, again over 8,000 pounds of pressurized cargo in this HTV vehicle. Also scheduled to take place early tomorrow will be the removal of the external payload. The flight controllers using the space station's robotic arm, which is currently grappled to the vehicle, to remove the CALED experiment inside of the unpressurized module, and then hand it off to the robotic arm over on the Japanese experiment module's exposed facility, where the experiment will be installed to be exposed to the environment of space, searching for any signs of dark matter and also the origin of cosmic rays. Again, all that to take place tomorrow following a successful berthing today. So again, just about 20 to 25 minutes away from the resumption of HTV-5 activities, getting it berthed to the Earth-facing side of Harmony and finishing up all of the work to get HTV attached to the International Space Station today. bands. So the video communication known as the KU coverage, the KU band, the high-rate data stream that enables the space station to send live video down to the ground, dropping out for the next couple of minutes. Again, we should be resuming the final stages of attaching HTV-5 to the International Space Station in about 10 to 15 minutes from now. Right now, the Expedition 44 crew taking a well-deserved break. All six crew members currently scheduled to be having their midday meal. You can see the crew of Expedition 44 here, a six-man contingent from countries around the globe, three Russian cosmonauts, two NASA astronauts, and one Japanese astronaut. They'll be Expedition 44 for only about another week or so. Or another 2 weeks, rather, sorry. Expedition 45 officially beginning once Gennady Padalka and the visiting crew members that'll be launching next week return home. And meanwhile, here inside Mission Control Houston, the Orbit 2 team now on console, taking over from the Orbit 1 team that oversaw all the final stages of HTV approach and grapple. The team now being led by Flight Director Greg Whitney, and you'll be hearing NASA astronaut Doug Wheelock, also known as Wheels, talking to the crew members on board once we resume the final installation phases for HTV-5. Again, just about 10 minutes or so until we'll be able to lock up that video coverage, giving the robotics flight controllers the view that they need to conduct all the final installation phases. The sun also coming up right around the time we'll reacquire that video communication. So giving them the necessary lighting conditions as well. And again, for now, we'll continue to stand by for the next 10 minutes or so until that video communication comes back up, and we'll be ready to watch HTV-5 get locked into place. Again, once we get confirmation of second stage capture, the vehicle will be firmly attached to the station, and then it's over to the crew to begin leak checks, scheduled to open up the hatches tomorrow morning. And this is Mission Control Houston with that video reacquired, ready to begin resuming the install of HTV-5. The robotics flight controller are going to start maneuvering the unmanned cargo craft into what's known as the ready-to-latch position. Once it's there and everything's checked out, they will hand it over to the crew on board and be able to engage the bolts in the common berthing, mechanism, get HTV attached, and all this cargo delivered to the station.
Decimal 521.
Wilco Scott, we have just a bit more maneuvering, and we'll give you a call here in just a few minutes.
Okay, copy. Thanks.
Station Houston on Space to Ground 2 for Scott and CBM Ops.
Hey, go ahead.
Yeah, Scott, we're ready to press in to RTLs. We'll meet you in 1.521 in step one. We'll give you a call here momentarily.
Okay, copy.
Station Houston on Space to Ground 2. No need to respond. We're past our constraints on the cupola shutters. You have a go to open those shutters whenever you would like.
Okay, copy. Thank you.
So again, we are in the final phases right now of HTV-5 being attached to the space station. Robotics controllers driving it into that ready-to-latch position. Once it arrives there, it'll be over to the crew members on board to begin the all the activities with the common berthing mechanism, the capture latches. Being driven, and then a total of 16 bolts being engaged to secure it in place.
Moving the arms so I can look for RTLs.
Affirmative, Scott. We'll let you know when we're getting close. Station Houston on Space Ground 2 for Scott. The arm's in motion now, and you can begin monitoring for RTLs.
Copy. Houston, currently only RTL 3 and 4.
We see the same, Scott. Thanks. Station Houston on Space to Ground 2 for Scott and CBM.
No.
Yes, sir. We see four good RTLs. We're in step one of 1.521. Maneuver to RTL complete. Go for first stage capture.
Okay, I see the RTLs. I'll go to step two.
Copy.
So NASA astronaut Scott Kelly on board the station, standing by now at the common berthing mechanism, ready to begin his job to attach HTV-5 to the station. Again, it's at RTL, so ready to latch position right now. It will be a first stage capture just to have some initial hold on the unmanned cargo craft, and then once second stage capture is confirmed, HTV will officially be berthed to the International Space Station. So that's the call out that we're going to wait for.
And I'm going to float on down the Russian segment and let them remind them about the exercise, and I'll be in step four here shortly.
Copy that, Scott. Thank you.
And you said I don't see anyone down there exercising. Shell's going to go down and remind them, and I'll continue here. They know about it, but we're just going to make sure.
Copy all, Scott. Thank you.
And Houston, you got to go for the SSRMS mode to limp.
Copy, Scott. Thank you.
So NASA astronaut Scott Kelly continuing to move down the list as he sends all of the commands to the common berthing mechanism to attach HTV-5 to the station. At this point, that first stage soft capture has been confirmed. So now they're waiting to basically park the space station's robotic arm. Once we get confirmation of second stage capture, HTV-5 will be attached, and that'll wrap up all the berthing operations for this morning.
Station Houston on Space Ground 2 for Scott. In step 5.1, SSRMS mode to limp complete. Go for second stage capture.
Copy. Go for second stage capture.
And Houston, understand you're ready for 5.3.2.
Affirmative, Scott. We're ready.
In all these template cases, I can assume those are already completed, right, when I get to them?
We will uplink one after the other, so as soon as you see the capture override, you have a go to confirm.
I understand, okay. Houston, here comes step 6 A bolts.
Copy, Scott. We're ready.
And at this point, Scott Kelly driving the bolts should be getting that second stage capture confirmation any moment.
Houston on 2, I'm ready to start the HCP stow whenever you guys are.
Copy, Chell, we're ready for that.
Okay, copy, I'm going to put that in work. And Houston on to MCC, HCP power off is complete.
We copy, Chell, thank you.
And again, we're continuing to stand by for that second stage capture confirmation.
Houston, Space Shuttle
Space Ground 2 for the CWC field from Love Condensate Tank.
Go ahead, Kimia.
Whenever you guys are ready, I'm going to start this procedure.
We are ready, Kimia, and in step 3.3, the quantity. And then, Kimia, in step 3.3, the quantity is 6 kilograms and the in 30 minutes for the time offload time.
Okay, understand. So step 3.3 is 6.0 kilogram and 30 minutes.
Good read back, Kimia.
And so just hearing the bolts are in place, second stage capture is confirmed, 9:02 a.m. Central Time this morning.